I must say that once again it's my true pleasure to be here. I'm very excited, and in the beginning I would like to declare my faith by saying my faith is bigger than my fear. Can we please all say together,
my faith is bigger than my fear.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Today's theme is choose your way. I'm not good in jokes, but let me share a joke with you. A wife went to her husband and said, I heard that husband and wife cannot live together in heaven. And the husband said, yes, you heard it right. And she said, why is that? And the husband said, that is why it's called heaven. So today we are going to talk about heaven and hell. And we need to choose our way. In the scripture, Matthew 25, the Bible says, the Son of Man will come in his glory with the angels around him, and he will sit on his throne. And the nations like us will be gathered in front of him, and he will separate one from another. Like a shepherd separate a sheep from a goat. Then the Bible says he will put the sheep on his right and the goat on his left. Let's talk about it. In this world, there are three kinds of people. First, the followers. You and I, we are proud that we follow Jesus Christ, but we need to be humble. The second ones are pretenders. Jesus called them hypocrites in the Bible as well. And the third are unbelievers. And when Jesus is saying sheep and goat, it represents believers and unbelievers. Today, it is very difficult for me to say that you are a follower, you are a pretender, you are unbeliever. People will not like it. And I'm not here to condemn anyone. I'm here to tell the word of God. I'm here to judge myself by word of God, and you can judge yourself as well, because we need to be believer to enter in the kingdom of God. And how we can know that what we are? The psalmist says in Psalm 90 verse 8, Lord, you have set our wickedness in front of you. Our secret sins are in the light of your presence. It means that God is looking what I am. God is looking what you are. And if insidely you know that there are certain sins in your life, certain sins in my life, we need to change. Because we can pretend in front of others, but we cannot pretend in front of God. Because Bible says our secret sins in the light of your presence. He can see everything. Brothers and sisters, today I would like to encourage you, if there is anything you can see in your life, please change it, because God is watching. Let me share another beautiful thing from the Bible. Jesus Christ, when he started his ministry, what he did? Before choosing his disciples, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 4, verse 17, at that time Jesus began to preach and said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near. So Jesus himself said the very first thing to repent. So today, if we need to be counted in sheep, we need to be repented. We need to choose a way. Either we can be a believer or unbeliever. And then the Bible says, the king said that, come, inherit the kingdom which is prepared for you from the beginning of the creation by my Father. It tells us that kingdom is always there. It is you and I who has to choose either we need to enter in the kingdom or not. We all know that what Adam did. We are living a sinful life, but we can change our life through Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ himself said the reason why we can enter, why we can be sheep. Because he says, I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. I was without clothes and you clothed me. I was sick and you came to me. I was in prison, you came to visit me. That is the reason why the sheep can go in heaven. That is the reason why believers can go in the heaven. This parable shows the act of mercy which we can do every day. We can feed someone, we can give clothes to someone, be nice to someone. If somebody is sick, we can go and visit them. And these things does not depend upon three things. Can be more. But the first, you don't need to be a wealthy. You don't need to have much ability or intelligence to do these kind of things, these acts of mercy. But let me remind you what Bible says. Because we all think that we are doing good. I'm doing everything what Lord has commanded. But James said something very amazing in James chapter 2 verses 15 and 16. And he says, suppose a brother or sister is without clothes and daily food. If one of you say to them, go in peace, keep warm and well fed, but does nothing about their physical needs, what good is it? So today we need to remind this word of God that can we see our brother or sister in need and what our actions are. And today when we talk about actions, John said very amazing thing in 1 John chapter 3 verse 18. He's saying to all of us, he's saying, dear children, let us not love with words or speech, but with actions and truth. So today, Jesus Christ wants to see us in action, not just saying good words, not just be our pretenders or unbelievers, but followers to show actions towards him. And then we see in the scripture, the righteous asked, Lord, when did we feed you? When we came to see you? When you were thirsty and we gave you water? When you were sick or in prison and we came to see you and visit you and look after you? And Jesus said, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers or sisters of mine, you did it for me. So anyone is doing any good for anyone is doing for Lord Jesus Christ, because that is said very clearly in Matthew 25, 40. And it was a big debate that who their brothers and sisters are. Some said that they are Jewish, some said that old Christians, some said are suffering people. But let me remind you what Jesus said again in Luke 10, 29 to the lawyer. When he came and asked that, who is my neighbor? And we all remember the story of Good Samaritan, what Jesus shared with him. He said that Good Samaritan, be a Good Samaritan, because a man was robbed when he was going from Jerusalem to Jericho. A priest came, did not look after him. A Levite came, went away, just talking and speaking, no actions. And then a Samaritan came, took him on his donkey, paid the money, took him in the inn, and showed actions and truth. That's what we need to be today. My brothers and sisters, if we can't be this, then it will be difficult for us to be counted as a sheep. And then we go further down in the scripture. And we see that he will say to the unrighteous people that depart from me, you who are cursed, and go into the eternal fire which is prepared for devil and his angels. This can happen those who pretend in this world, those who are unbelievers, who are not following the teaching of Jesus Christ. So today we need to find out the way through which we can enter in the kingdom of heaven and be a sheep to him. And then Jesus said that, I was hungry and you did not come to me, feed me. I was thirsty, you gave nothing to drink. I was in prison, I was sick, I needed clothes, and I was a stranger, and you done nothing for me. And they said, Lord, when we did that? And then again Lord said, whenever you did not do anything, one of the least of these, you did not do it for me. Today I would like to encourage you that either you are going through suffering, a problem, affliction, chaos in your life, Jesus Christ is with you. Because he says that when I was hungry, I mean you and I can be hungry today, but Jesus felt that hunger. If I was thirsty, Jesus is feeling our thirst, either it can be a physical or a spiritual. He knows what going through. If we are a stranger, Jesus is a stranger. And from the Bible, I would like to encourage you with a beautiful passage in Acts when we see Paul, Apostle Paul was going. He was called Saul that time and he was on the way of Damascus to persecute Christians. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 9 verse 4 and 5, Paul, he fell on the ground and heard a voice say to him, that time he was Saul. The voice said, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? And he said that, who are you, Lord? The voice said, I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. It means when Saul was persecuting the Christians, he was persecuting the Jesus Christ himself. That was Jesus who spoke to him. Today, if anyone is persecuting us, they are persecuting Jesus Christ. And they will not enter in the kingdom of heaven. That's what the Bible says. I'm not saying that. They can be counted as a goats. If you and I are doing the same thing somehow, persecuting somebody by our actions or words, we can be counted as goats. Again, I would like to ask you, which way you want to choose? You want it to be on the right as a sheep, or you want it to be on the left as a goat? Because if we will be counted as a goat, it is very distressing. Because in the end, Jesus Christ, sitting on a throne, he said that unrighteous, the goats, they will go into the eternal punishment, and the righteous will go into the eternal life. That's what the Bible says in Matthew 25:46. Two ways, eternal punishment or eternal life. We all need to go and wants to and love to go in eternal life, which is heaven. But today, it's my responsibility to tell you what is eternal punishment as well. Mostly we don't talk about these things. We always talk about mercy and grace, and we are glad that we are living in this kind of in the mercy and grace of Jesus Christ. But we need to know that judgment is final, and if we don't count it as a sheep, the judgment will come. And eternal punishment is hell, which is also called Gehenna. There are three words in the Bible represents eternal punishment. The very first one is Sheol. It is called grave. It is used in the Old Testament, and Prophet Jonah used that word in Jonah chapter 2 verse 2. Prophet Jonah is saying when he was in the belly of fish, he said, out of the belly of Sheol, I cried out and you heard my voice. It means he's saying that I am in the grave and I'm calling you and you heard my voice. And the second word is Hades. Hades is a word which is used in New Testament for Sheol. It is a Greek word which means underground. And Jesus Christ himself used that word in the Bible in Revelation chapter 1 verse 18. Jesus said, I am the living one. I was dead. Behold, I am alive forever and ever. And I hold the keys of death and Hades. So again, Jesus is saying that I hold the keys. So if today you and I can feel that we are in sort of grave or in a situation where we cannot come out, it can be our financial problem, a relationship problem, a social problem, a job problem, a sickness, or anything. But Jesus has the keys. If you and I are in the thinking that that is the end, Jonah was thinking that that's the end, but he was saved. So today you and I can be out of that situation before we go to the eternal punishment if we not chosen as sheep. Even today we have opportunity to come out of our situation by just holding his hand. And the third one is hell. Nobody would like to talk about hell. Nobody wants to go to the hell. The third is hell, which is also called Gehenna. And that is after the valley of Hinnom in Jerusalem. Gehenna. And that valley was used for the sacrifice of children by fire to the pagan gods. That's how the name called Gehenna and then hell. And it is also called Lake of Fire in the Bible as well. And that will be a final and eternal stage of those who don't believe, who pretend, who are not following Jesus Christ. Because that day he will say, I don't know you. And we need to tell people about it, that we need to be saved, we need to follow the right way. So today is a way to choose. We get very upset sometimes in our lives that where we can go. But brothers and sisters, I encourage you to be on the right path, to be the way Jesus is telling, on the right hand side. We need to be counted as a sheep, not as a goat. May God bless you all and keep using you for his glory. Amen.
Amen. Amen.